we will be continuing with the asexual reproduction part. Okay, so other than fragmentation, budding, arthrospore formations, etc., as I was telling you, we have the formation of spores. Okay, so coming back to the topic here, you can see that there's a synergistic mycelium and development of aerial mycelium. Okay, the contents of the cytoplasm will move through this sporangium. This is called sporangiophore. Okay, this is called sporangiophore. And this is sporangium which is going to be developed. So here you can see that the sporangiophore extends and gives a very huge vesicular structure in which all the cytoplasmic contents will flow, and the nucleus will be present inside. Many nuclei will be present inside the sac-like structure. So what do you observe here? There's another small vacuole developing. The vacuole keeps on expanding, if you see the difference. Okay, and the main concept of spore formation is the cleavage, cytoplasmic cleavage. That means what? The cytoplasm will cleave into small bits, pieces. Each bit carries one nucleus in it. So you can see this picture where each bit has one nucleus. That gets rounded off into a spore. And the columella keeps on expanding. It's a vacuum. Vacuolated region which keeps expanding and gives pressure on the spore wall. So what is this called? Sporangium. Okay, in the sporangium you have columella and spore sac. This is called spore sac. Columella, spore sac. Okay, columella exerts pressure on this sporangial wall, and eventually what happens is the wall will rupture and all the spores are released. If you observe here, whatever example I have taken, these spores are not having flagella. So they are aplanospores, which is produced. This, whatever you are learning, is typical example of rhizopus, what you study. In the form studies, you will study different types of fungi. This is the mechanism of asexual reproduction in rhizopus, which produces non-motile spores. Okay? And these spores, whichever is released, imagine these spores are released into the atmosphere. They fall on any other food or any substratum, it again regenerates a new mycelium. So every spore which is here, what you're seeing, will become a new mycelium. It develops into a thread-like structure and again produces similar concept. The cycle continues to produce another structure like this with a sporangium, cytoplasmic cleavage, then each bit of the cytoplasmic bit becomes a spore, columella, spore sac, and spores getting released. That's how the asexual reproduction keeps on continuing. I think you got it. What is the meaning of sporangium? So keep the keywords in mind. Sporangium, cytoplasmic cleavage, columella, the vacuolated region, and the spore sac. If you have these keywords, that means you've understood how the sporangium helps in producing spores. Okay, so the next one what you're learning is about formation of conidia. There's a difference between spore and conidia. Please remember, spores were formed inside the sac-like structure. Okay, but here I've taken an example of a conidia. I think you've seen this. This is the structure of a fungus which you learned in the lab. If you recollect it, it is penicillium. Okay, so I've tried to give the keywords here in this just to make your understanding more simple. So this is the mycelium which is having septate nature. That was not having septate nature. That was synocytic, and this is septate mycelium. Here also it's giving aerial mycelium. Here the structure is called conidiophore. Please remember, conidiophore, that is sporangiophore. Wherever spore is produced, sporangium is produced, sporangiophore. Wherever conidia is produced, the structure is called conidiophore. C-O-N-I-D-I, conidio, O-P-H-O-R-E, conidiophore. Okay, and this conidiophore, in this condition, it is showing some branching. Okay, and that branching has been extended further into bottle-shaped structure called stigmata. See here, conidiophore, this is conidiophore, this is bottle-shaped stigmata. Okay, and the bottle-shaped stigmata carries the mother nucleus. See, this is the mother nucleus. Okay, mother nucleus produces, so this is a bottle shaped syringmata, which is giving a chain of conidia. What is chain of conidia? So the syringmata will show small extensions and produce many conidia like a chain. Okay, whichever branch is bearing the syringmata is called metulae. See here. Whichever branch does not carry syringmata is called rami. This concept is called basipetal succession. What is basipetal succession? You can find the oldest conidia in the tip and youngest conidia at the base. That's the meaning of basipetal succession. I have a better picture of this in the next slide, in the next picture, which will show you how this basipetal succession actually exists. So what is this? Formation of conidia. This is called conidiomata. The structure is called conidiomata. There it's called sporangium. Here it's called conidiomata. And it's going to give syringmata. That's the difference. Okay, please make a note of the words syringmata, mother nucleus, protoplast extension, chains of conidia, basipetal succession. These all are some definitions which are commonly asked in the examinations. Coming to the similar one, another one formation of conidia is there, you are observing here. This is penicillium and that is aspergillus. See the difference. Okay, can you see the difference? You can find here the syringmata is a bottle shaped with the help of conidiomata structure. But here what do you find? Vesicle. See, you find a similar vesicle. There's no vesicle in other conidia formation. In penicillium, you didn't find vesicle here. Please note that. The mycelium is living airway mycelium. Vesicle here. Okay. Here the syringmata is going to form on the wall of this vesicle. Okay. There's no branching here. You can find syringmata, bottle shaped syringmata developing on the wall of this vesicle. Okay. Cytoplasmic contents will move. This cell is called foot cell. Foot cell, okay, which gives rise to this conidiophore vesicle with later on becoming many foldings called bottle-shaped syringmata. See, I was telling you about basipetal succession. Observe one picture of this here. This bottle-shaped syringmata has got the nucleus. This is a mother nucleus. This will produce the, by protoplast extension, mitotic division. Please remember mitotic division. 2N, 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 all are 2N, okay. So it keeps on replicating and giving the new one to the new protoplast extension. That is why you find youngest one here, oldest one in the tip. Such a concept is called basipetal succession. What is basipetal succession? Conidia, oldest conidia in the tip. See, oldest conidia in the tip. See, it's bigger. Youngest conidia is in the base. That's why it's called basipetal succession. Same thing has been shown here also. Mother nucleus, protoplast extension, see, mitotic division, conidia mode. So, you can find that this is a chain of conidia. Each conidia gets dispersed by air current. Each one will germinate like a seed only and gives rise to a new mycelium. Okay, see, I want to show you one similar picture here. See this? How does it look? You can find the vesicle, over the vesicle, so many syringmata are observed. See that here you can see conidia, see extension, how it's happening. See, they all are chains of conidia. See, chains of conidia. These are all chains of conidia. Like you can find it as if, like, if you imagine a rubber ball, on the rubber ball you put pins completely and from the pins you extend some beads, how it looks. Or thermocol beads, very much like that. So, aspergillus have a unique feature of vesicle formation. Okay, that's what you're seeing here. Whereas penicillium is different, brush-like appearance. I think in the practical sessions, I have told you. Penicillium is brush-like appearance, isn't it? See here, it is like a brush. Penicillus means brush in Latin. Penicillus means brush, okay? And here it is vesicular in nature. You have to note the difference, okay? So today's class, in this session, what you have learnt, how a spore is formed and how a conidia is formed, okay? So, this is how an aspergillus, what's the common name for aspergillus? Black mold. What's the common name for penicillium? Green mold. Okay. Now, I'll be continuing with the sexual reproduction study. Okay, shall we go for the next session for the sexual reproduction? Till then, please practice all these terms. Please understand what is stigmata, what is conidia for, what is mother nucleus. All these terms you have to be familiar with. Then, in the coming one more session, I'll be teaching completely about the part of sexual reproduction. Till now, we didn't see meiosis. We saw only mitosis. Okay, mitosis means one nucleus is existing, divides mitotically, means equal division. Go back to your POC. You have studied about mitosis. Okay, equal division. Okay, it's not a reduction division. So the genetics passes on to the conidia as such. So every conidia what you are seeing here is all 2N, 2N nucleus. Okay, each one will develop into a new mycelium. All are 2N. Okay, no? So I think you are familiar with what is conidia, what is spore. Please don't have any confusion in this. Spores are formed inside the sporangium. Conidia are formed outside in the conidia metallic structure with the help of a stigmata. Okay. So, please look into those terms. I'll meet you again for sexual reproduction part of the study. Thank you.